you some hair of the hound. Got any vodka?
You, white one, think your two swords could take on 40?
What do you want?
Want to talk to the Peller?
Too late. We've got dibs on a chat with him. A long one.
What do you want from him?
To give him what he deserves.
And that is?
He done conjured auguries. Said something evil had made its nest in Edric's bowels. Told Edric to eat rowan berries. Lots of them.
Ever since Edric's lived in the outhouse. And he's got hardened pustules all over him.
Just so happens I need the Peller alive. So if you agree to leave him alone, for good, I'm willing to tell you how to help Edric.
Well, all in all...
Yes or no?
Fine. Let's hear it.
A tea of mullein leaves for his belly, and cover his boils with mallow. A few days and he'll be good as new.
Noted. But if it don't work, we'll be back. Move out, boys.
You muttering?
Gotta wonder about a man who could get Edric's friends all worked up. Hey, anybody home? Open up, it's safe now.
Devils? Who do they bring? What seek ye?
I need your help.
Whoa, a man. Nay, a wolf. Grey, though not old. Tis he the Peller awaits.
Recognize this? Made of spruce wood, strong smell of juniper, designed to protect someone.
Freshly cut spruce, sprinkled with goat's blood, then tempered with an incense of earth, smoke, and juniper. For Anna, to protect her.
So, designed to protect her. From what?
Oh, the dear. Besieged she was, evil all around, wanting to possess her. Old magic, born of oblivion, from dark sources emerged.
Old magic? Can you be more specific?
Tis not for mouth speech, nor for the touch. A small protective charm, not a thing more a Peller could do.
You make the amulet?
Aye, sure 'twas the Peller. After the way of his forefathers, over still water in the light of a full moon. Proper as amulets go. It protected well. Should never have taken it off.
Anna and her daughter are missing. Know where they are?
Nay, no, nay. Peller don't know. But the spirits could know. The Peller will augur, the spirits ask.
Spirits, great. Fine with me. Long as I know where to look, where to find them.
Lost, must be found. Princess! None better than princess for finding things.
Princess? Which princess?
Princess! My goat! She's fled!
Those men must have scared her off. Can we get back to the auguring?
Without the goat? Impossible. No goat. Won't work.
Will you help me if I bring the goat back?
Princess! Where have you got to, girl?
Fine. I'll get your goat.
The bell. The little bell's ringing. She loves it. Ring, ring, and she will follow. But for a while. But beware of wild strawberries. Raspberries, too.
Yeah, treacherous as beasts go. I always keep an eye out for them. This way, I think. Another clue. Good. Good. Another clue. Good. Here, goat. Here, princess. Hoofed and horned. Should have known it would be stubborn. All right, time to try the bell. Come on, let's go see the peller. Take you back to the peller. Misses you something awful. Come on, damn it. You go.
bear. Run, you stupid piece of shit.
I really have to keep ringing this bell for you to follow. You're no roach, but I bet we could be friends in time. You've got that all-important quality every roach has to have. You don't talk much.
Princess, flee not from the pelt. Give us a round. Goat of mine, dearest, sweetest goat.
Happy for you, but I'm kinda in a hurry. Anna and Tamara, they might be in danger.
The White Wolf helped the Pella, and so the Pella shall help him. Blood. We need blood. A living being.
Fine. Be right back. Do. It's over? Is that it?
That is it.
Spirits had nothing more to say? Like where they went or where they are now?
You came for an augury, and augur I did. They're gone, the child remains.
Mentioned a child. Whose?
Why, Anna's.
Anna was pregnant?
She was. And she miscarried.
Baron didn't mention it.
Afraid, perhaps. Or ashamed, or forgetful, or perhaps he had no wish to remember.
Anna tell you all this? Did she come here after it happened?
Nay, not Anna. 'Twas the omens told me.
Great, so I can be sure it's true.
The omens need not your faith to be true. It is you who needs the omens to lead you to truth.
The Baron have anything to do with his wife's miscarriage?
Foul-tempered he is, and he's a fondness for hooch.
No doubt makes his temper even fouler. Did he abuse his family? Anna came to you, you must have noticed something.
The Pella's old, near blind. But Princess came and licked her hand.
So what?
She's a wise beast. Only comes to those who suffer.
What happened to the child?
In a grave thrown, without rite or ceremony, it awoke. Now it wanders, it seeks vengeance.
A botchling.
White wolf, wise wolf, catch the botchling. The botchling will help. Lead the wolf to the loved ones.
Botchlings suck the blood of pregnant women and eat their fetuses. They don't help.
'Tis a being cursed, and witches lift curses. If the white wolf can't lift it, he should bring me its blood. Blood will always find kindred blood.
Heard of one witcher who lifted a botchling's curse. Never tried it myself, though. I know you need to bury it under the threshold.
And give it a name. Perform the I'm Roin.
The ritual of naming? That's an elven custom.
Human, elven, dwarven, ancient. Spirits have no race. They honor not its meaning. Win a spirit's favor, and the spirit shall aid you. Ask, and it will answer. Seek, and it will show you the way.
Whatever I do, I gotta find the botchling first.
Seek it at midnight, near the grave that lies empty.
If what you say is true, the Baron ought to know where that grave is.
That's it, Roach. Slow now.
Strike.
Take it easy. Come on, Roach. Thank you.
it down. Oswin? Where's Oswin? Anyone seen him?
I believe I saw him heading to the stable.
What?
Fire. You blind? Nobody willing to put it out?
Ain't that simple. Most are afraid. Baron flies into a rage. He takes no prisoners.
My brother's in the stable. We've got to save him. He'll burn alive. Him and the horses.
See what I can do.
Hurry now, quick! You, where do I know you from, eh? Ah, right, the Witcher! Come, drink with me! Pale as a ghost you are.
I know your wife miscarried. Was that before or after you beat her to a pulp?
What the fuck are you suggesting?
Don't play me for a fool. You'd been beating them for years. Finally, they'd had enough and fled. Sound about right? Shit, fire's spreading. They ran from you, didn't they?
Lying prick!
Not good. Sit down. You beat them.
I never laid a finger on Tamara. Not once.
And on Anna?
That's another story. She always knew how to spark my ire.
Expect me to believe you are a loving father to Tamara after that scene in the courtyard?
You're free to believe whatever you wish, but she was always the apple of my eye. She had the run of the place, ask anyone. She'd ride the horses, hunt with the men, at times join them on their rounds. And they'd send for her when I flew into a rage, for only she could calm me.
Make it sound like she led a charmed life. If that's the case, why'd she run?
I'd hardly need you if I knew.
You knew they had run away from the start.
Yes, I knew.
Why didn't you tell me? Wasted my time.
Say I had. Say I'd said I had troubles. Couldn't control my wife, my daughter. What kind of flaccid prick would you take me for?
Gotta admit, I do think you're a prick. Not because you couldn't control them, but because you drove them away.
What?
Don't play the idiot. You gave them no choice.
Anna and I. It wasn't as it seemed. Seems.
All right, I'm all ears. Tell me what happened. The truth this time.
I'd been soaking myself 3 days straight. Anna came to me, said they were leaving.
I begged them to stay. She refused to hear it. I tried to stop her. She wriggled like an eel. We struggled. She fell. Last blasted thing I remember. Woke up in the morn, breeches heavy with my own piss. A large bump on my head. Sadly, they were gone. Know what that's like, Witcher? No. How the fuck could you? I was left with nothing. Nothing! Only the bottle.
Signs of a fight in the room. Hole in the wall, wine all over the landing. Was that you?
Aye. We tussled. She tried to whack me on the noggin with a candlestick, but kept missing. Hit the wall and the pillar instead. I staggered backwards onto the table, spilled the wine, slipped and tumbled. Anna used that moment to flee. She rushed down the stairs, still clutching that damn candlestick. I caught her on the landing. We fell. I thought I had her. Then she turned and smacked me in the head. I blacked out. Don't know what happened next. When I came to, I was alone.
Tamara present for all this? She see you quarrel?
Through the doorway, perhaps. She didn't enter the room. Shame, too. Things might have turned out differently. The sight of her always calmed me.
What happened next?
Next? It only got worse. I awoke at sunset, not knowing how many days had passed. Thought it was all a ploughing, drunken nightmare. And then I went to the bedchamber, and Anna was not there. Instead, there was blood everywhere. I knew she'd miscarried. My breath short, my throat locked. I neared the bed and saw it. It lay there, a tiny thing, defenseless, on bloodied sheets, dead. And it was my doing.
Seen a lot of dead in my time, but that must have been hard.
Unspeakably so. My legs gave out. I saw fields of corpses at Sodden. Saw witches burn in Maribor. But compared to this, all that was a rabbit's prick alongside a great oak. And the guilt is all mine.
We don't know that yet. The amulet Anna wore could be linked somehow. Maybe the fact that she lost it. What did you do with the child?
Wrapped it in a clean sheet and buried it.
Just like that?
Damn you! I gave no thought to a funeral. It was a horror. I wanted it to end. That child had been my dream. I told Anna, the little one, our little one, to make things right. Yet she died before she could be born. Understand, Witcher. My child was dead.
Get hold of yourself. Men like you, when they break down, look downright pathetic.
You're a heartless bastard.
Mutations worked then. But here's the good news. Your dead child might help us find the one who's still alive. And your wife.
What? How?
Sometimes miscarried fetuses, if they don't get a proper burial, turn into botchlings.
Into fucking what?
A cursed creature that draws strength from killing pregnant women. Once it's strong enough, it attacks those who scorned it.
But how? How does it know?
Blood ties. They're a strong bond. A bond I want to use to find your family.
How?
One of two ways. Legends claim you can bury a botchling under the family's threshold, perform a ritual, and turn it into a lubberkin. That's a sort of, hob, a guardian spirit that could lead me to your family.
And the other way?
We kill it and draw some blood. Take that to the Peller and he does the rest.
Do not kill my child. It's suffered enough already. Lift the curse that it may finally rest in peace.
Still not sure what to do.
Whatever you decide, we must put an end to my child's suffering.
Whatever we do, we gotta find the botchling first.
I'll show you where I buried her, and I'll dig the grave at my threshold.
If it turns out we can't transform the botchling into a lubberkin, they can bury us in it. Handy either way. The sooner we resolve this, the better. Best do it tonight, at midnight.
Then wait here with me. Near midnight, I'll take you to where I buried her.
Get word to the common folk. Let us stay in their homes tonight and draw a line of salt outside their doors. And try to sober up.
Do I take a shovel to dig up the grave?
Take it. You'll need it, but not for that.
A bit further. Follow me.
You give the child a name?
No. Why would we?
Mistake. Names are powerful seals.
Here's the spot.
Chose a lovely spot.
Damn it, will you relent? I'm plowing now I've done wrong.
Good. The grave's dug up and empty.
What's that mean?
Botchling's on the prowl.
It'll bite us in the arse before we know it!
Keep screaming and it will turn rabid. It's calm for now.
Bloody hell! What happens when it gets plowing restless?
It'll bite through your jugular, and you'll bleed to death before I can help. Tell me if it starts wriggling. I'll calm it with magic. Pick it up. Take it in your arms.
Merciful gods!
Back to the fortress.
What? With this?
As I recall, you were the one who wanted to test the old legends, change it into a lubricant.
Oh, fuck.
Arm it somehow!
Oh. Quiet now. But what do you want to do with it?
Me? Nothing. This is your job. Told you, gotta bury it under the threshold. If the tales are true, by tomorrow it'll be a lubricant. From then on, it'll watch over your house and help me find your family. Chosen a name?
No.
So think of one. It's important.
It's a girl. What would Anna have named her? But who I did not embrace.
I name thee, say her name, and embrace thee as my daughter.
I name thee, Daya, and embrace thee as my daughter.
Good. Now bury the body.
What now?
In one day's time, Daya should turn into a lubberkin. I'll stay here and wait. You go home.
I'll wait with you.
Out of the question.
But that's my child. And the guilt, the responsibility for all this, lies with me.
Time for parental impulses? It's long past. Besides, nothing else you can do here.
But...
No buts. Just Witcher's work left to do here. Gotta wait a day and a night for the botchling to turn into a lubberkin. That's it. Go home. And try not to drink yourself stupid again. By blood's power, I summon you. With your name, I beseech you. Hear my call and arise, Dea. Lead me to those bound to you by blood. They kept in there. Might be worth looking around, though. A bracelet. One of them must have dropped it. Horseshoe. No way a pitch burner could afford a horse. Clothing. They change in here? Both were here. I'm going the right way. To show me something more. Yeah. What do we have here? Bones have been here a while. Chewed on the saddle. Necrophages will eat anything these days. Giant claws. Wasn't a necrophage made these marks. Horseshoes missing. Is this the animal that lost one in the smokehouse? Head torn clear off. Takes incredible strength. Must have been attacked by a powerful beast. Surprised him. Hope they got away. Trail goes on. Good thing it doesn't end here. Fisherman's hut. Seems she wants me to take a closer look.
Who's that?
At the room. Go on now.
What you seek here, sir? Our hut's out of the way. Woeful. We has nothing. We knows nothing.
Just need information. Looking for two women, the Bloody Baron's wife and daughter.
Not a soul have been here, sir.
Sure, not even passing through. Daughter's medium height, about 20. Her mother's thin, about 40. Seen them?
That sir came at night, right, Mummy?
Quiet, boy!
Where'd the girl go? Your son said enough, no point in playing dumb anymore.
Sorry, sir. But you don't look like one of her father's men.
Because I'm not. I'm looking for Tamara and her mother. I need to know if they're alive and safe.
Tamara is, aye. She's to my brother's place in Oxenford. But Mrs. Anna, that's another tale.
Though anywhere's better than the crow's perch with a baron.
Why?
Cause he beat her, sir. Beat Mrs. Anna, I mean. Everyone knew, but not a one lifted a finger for to stop it.
What happened to Tamara's mother?
Twas like this. I was awaiting in the old smokehouse with horses. Cold as hell and so dark, couldn't see past two elves in front of you. Moon had arisen high, and still they hadn't come. Began to fear some demon had snatched them. But finally, they came forth, and we sets off towards the river. Suddenly, out of nowhere, a gale arose. Thought it'd tear my head off. And those damn birds, swarms of them coursing o'er the woods, raising a racket to make your ears bleed. Mrs. Anna screamed, bent over into herself. Tamara knelt down, gripped her arms. But then I saw it. Fiery marks on her hands.
What marks?
These, well, like burned on with hot iron. On the palms, inside.
Burned? Like a cattle brand?
Aye, though these wasn't black scars scabbed over. These hot and glowing, as if they'd burn with raw fire.
Fine, what happened next?
Grew even darker. Seemed someone had put out the stars. Crickets all went silent of a sudden, And then, from the woods, a roar. Broke out in a cold sweat, and before I could catch my breath, a beast jumped out of the woods, big as a barn, with horns and two burning coals for eyes. I thought I was done for. Beast attacked Mrs. Anna's horse, ripped its head off, carried her off into the woods. Our horses, mine and Miss Tamara's, got spooked and tore off willy-nilly. T'were the only reason we escaped.
The miss wanted to go back for her mother, but my wife pleaded, said she'd die out there alone. Miss Tamara agreed not to go.
Why help them at all? You risked a lot.
I did that. Old Miss Tamara. 3 moons passed, a fever gripped my boy. We thought he was done for. Tamara alerted, brought food and salves. We're poorer than dirt itself. She saved my boy. No two ways about it. Me, myself, I'd have never dared to help. But my missus told me a time of war and contempt's come, a time of folk gone wrong. We needs to repay good with good. Who stands by idly does evil as if.
Married a wise woman.
Crying shame we couldn't save Mrs. Anna in the end.
Thanks for your help.
The lady, she'll be all right in the end, won't she?
I'll do what I can to see that she is. So here our paths diverge. Thank you, Dea. Go in peace.